Hello, topic of today's session is fuzzy logic control techniques for smart sensors. Why do we want to measure? This is an obvious question that might arise in our minds. There goes a well-known best statement: to measure is to know. We all are very inquisitive regarding the different parameters or values of different variables, and that is why we are always eager to measure different variables or different parameters. This also refers to the great importance of carrying out measurements to make definite and factual information available. You can compare, calculate, predict, and also examine or cross-check with figures. Measuring does provide insight into things that go well and sometimes that do not go well. What are the capabilities of sensors? With a sensor, a machine observes the environment and information can be collected or acquired. A sensor measures a physical quantity and then it converts this physical quantity into a signal, maybe electrical signal or optical signal, and so on. Sensors transform measurements or convert measurements from the real world into appropriate data for the digital domain. What is the objective? Objective is to detect events or changes in the environment. A sensor is always employed with other electronics. It could be as simple as a lamp or as complex as a computer. Today, advanced chip technologies make it possible to integrate all the required functions of sensors at low cost. It is economical. In a small volume, it is very compact, it is very tiny, and with low energy consumption or low power consumption. So therefore, these three parameters, that is low cost, small volume, and low power consumption, they are the desirable characteristics of sensor. The number of sensors around us is increasing rapidly. That is our observation. Estimates may vary from person to person or agency to agency, but many believe that by 2020, more than 50 billion sensors will be connected to each other via the Internet of Things. What is smart sensor? Smart sensors are basic sensing elements with embedded intelligence. This is the block diagram of smart sensor system. On the left hand side, we have the inputs. Input is also known as stimulus. It could be physical or chemical stimulus. Physical input signal or chemical input signal. On the right hand side, we have two signals here. One is the output. Output is, what is the output? Processed sensor information to user. So sensor produces this information and it is useful to the user. The second signal, which is very important, this is user commands for sensor operation. This is the input. So user commands for sensor operation, it is the input, and this is the primary input, physical or chemical stimulus. Within the smart sensor system, you can see sensors followed by this block, analog to digital converter, digital to analog converter, and signal processing. In signal processing, we have instrumentation amplifier, filter, and so on. So this is the important block. And then we have here communications, electrical or optical. So how sensor will communicate with the external world, that is the user or the environment, It can communicate with the help of this important module, communication, electrical communication or optical communication. This is the interface. And of course, every module or all modules need power for their proper operation. So this is the power module. In artificial intelligence, we study adaptive and intelligent systems. What is the objective? Copy human reasoning. What is human reasoning? All human beings, they used to reason, or they reason in languages or natural languages. It is mostly in the form of linguistic reasoning. What are the main constituents of artificial intelligence? First is fuzzy systems, that we are covering these fuzzy systems in this session. Neural networks we have already covered. Evolutionary computing or genetic algorithms, that is the third major. This is the third major ingredient or constituent. And the fourth one is probabilistic reasoning. And what is this fuzzy system? What are these fuzzy systems about? Fuzzy systems deal with imprecision. So this imprecision is the key for fuzzy systems, for the operation or working of fuzzy systems. We all human beings, we speak natural languages, and when we speak or when we explain something in our natural language, then we are not very precise. So this natural language or our explanation, our description may be with some imprecision. The neural networks, they deal with learning. Probabilistic reasoning deals with uncertainty. And evolutionary computing or genetic algorithms, they deal with optimization, unconstrained optimization, either minimization or maximization.
This block diagram depicts a user-friendly interface for artificial intelligence. Our phenomenon under study. It can be classified into two categories. One is mathematical world. Everything is definite or precise in this mathematical world. On the other hand, we have linguistic world. It is full of soft data, interpretations, understanding, explanations. And in mathematical world, we have quantitative methods and bivalent reasoning, either true or false, either 0 or 1. This is crisp logic. In the linguistic world or soft data, here natural languages are involved. Different qualitative methods exist, and the reasoning may be bivalent or multivalent. So there are many shades in between true and false, or in between 0 and 1. And these two categories, they are covered under the umbrella of soft computing approach. And soft computing approach is a subset of artificial intelligence. You know, the world is uncertain and we don't often need precision. For example, while driving a car, you need not know the working principles or the mechanism of carburetor, engine, and so on in order to learn how to drive a car. So that precision is not required when you want to learn a car. Similarly, here look at this block diagram, or look at this photograph. What does it show? It shows an asteroid approaching towards a person, this green person. So this event is observed by two persons simultaneously. One person is this blue colored person. This person is a man of precision. Another person, who is also simultaneously observing this event, this is a red colored person, but this is not a man of precision. This is a man of significance, rather, I would like to say. Now, the same event, how this same event is perceived by this person and this person. And what is the intention of these two persons? These persons would like to warn this green colored person because this asteroid might collide with this person. So see, the man of precision, how does he react to this situation? He would shout, a 1500 kilogram mass is approaching your head at 45.3 meter per second. This is the velocity. This is the precision. And then we have another person. And how does he react to this situation? He would shout, look out. So he is not specifying like the mass of the asteroid or velocity at which the asteroid is approaching. He is simply shouting, look out. So this is significance. And try to compare precision with significance. Do we human beings require precision or significance? Whenever you are talking, whenever you are communicating your ideas, your opinion with others, you are not talking very precisely or exactly. For example, whenever you are touching water in a glass, then you may not say the temperature of water is say 32 degrees Celsius or 40 degrees Celsius or 18 degrees Celsius. You may simply say water is lukewarm, water is warm, water is hot, water is very hot. So what are these terms? Lukewarm, warm, hot, very hot, cold, very cold. What are these terms? All these terms are fuzzy terms. Only significance is described over here, because they are not exactly defining the temperature. Temperature, very cold or lukewarm or warm. What are the ranges of the temperatures? So whenever we are speaking, whenever we are communicating our ideas, we are not talking very definite, or we are not talking very precise terms. So that is not our ability, basically. This is how human beings communicate. This is how human beings perceive. This is how human beings take decisions and so on. What are the different advantages of artificial intelligence? These models are based on human reasoning, and models can be linguistic. See, just now we have seen this linguistic. Then simple models. In simple models, no number crunching is involved here. The model is understandable, comprehensible. There are no black boxes. Everything is known precisely. The model is fast in computing. So regarding the space complexity and time complexity, when both space as well as time complexity is optimal, then the model can be fast in computing, and the model can be good in practice, that is a pragmatic model. Now looking to explore and exploit data. Why we would like to explore and exploit data? There are different types of data. Now data that is uncertain. What type of data is important? Data that is uncertain, there is no certainty. This data has missing items or missing terms, missing values in between. Suppose there is a time series and in between we have several missing values or missing items. And here we are looking for patterns. We are looking, we are investigating, we are searching for patterns. We wish to copy experts, and we want the computer to help make decisions. Fuzzy system was introduced by Zadeh in 1960s. So Zadeh is a pioneer or founder of this fuzzy systems. Fuzzy systems deal with imprecise entities in automated environments. It is based on fuzzy set theory and fuzzy logic. This was developed by Zadeh in 60s. And most of the applications are noticed in control and decision making. I would like to bring to your kind attention that MATLAB has a full-fledged fuzzy logic toolbox. MATLAB is a popular environment simulation. and Omron Electronics had developed Omron's fuzzy processor a decade ago. This is Omron FP3000. This is made in Japan.
Fuzzy logic is a branch of logic which uses degrees of membership in sets rather than a strict true or false membership. In CRISP logic, element may be true, element may be false. But in the case of fuzzy logic, degrees of membership they are defined. Fuzzy logic is the mathematical evaluation of any problem based on the degrees of truth. The conventional logic needs the problem statement be either true or false in entirety. Conventional logic or CRISP logic. Either the element is true or element is false. But in between true and false, we are not assigning any value of the membership for the element. Whereas fuzzy logic gives the shades of truth and false in the same statement. Let us consider one example of fuzzy logic. Suppose we have three persons A, B and C, aged 10, age of A is 10 years, age of B is 40 years, age of person C is 70 years, and then we ask a person D of age 90 years about the old age or youth of A, B, C. So we are inquiring a person aged 90 years regarding the old age or youth of these persons A, B and C. So how person D would reply? This person D would reply that all are young, all A, B, C are young. But if the same question is asked to another person of 30 years old, how will he answer? How will he react? The reply would be B and C are old. B and C are old while A being young. So these replies are different. So it is relative. Replies are different. For a 6 feet tall person, 5 feet and 8 inches may not be a tall height. But for 5 feet tall person, the same height, 5 feet and 8 inches, is considered as tall. Then another popular example, say Amitabh Bachchan is a tall actor. It is really very hot today. So what are these terms? Tall, very hot. These are fuzzy quantifiers or these are fuzzy terms. The interpretation of these fuzzy terms may vary from subject to subject. It may vary from continent to continent. It may depend on the demography and so on. Fuzzy logic, the conventional logic, is also known as CRISP logic. It doesn't add the viewpoint in determining the solution to any problem statement. Whereas in fuzzy logic system, the viewpoint of observer or evaluator, assessor, is integrated. See, this is very important. In fuzzy logic system, the viewpoint or opinion of observer or evaluator or assessor is integrated in offering or recommending solution to a particular problem. So this is the importance of fuzzy logic. So this is the crux. What is fuzzy thinking? Experts agree on a common sense when they solve the problems. Human experts, of course, they agree on common sense when they solve the problems. How can we represent expert knowledge that uses unclear, vague and ambiguous terms in a computer? How can we represent expert knowledge? Fuzzy logic is not logic that is fuzzy. Please bear in mind, fuzzy logic is not a logic that is fuzzy. Fuzzy means imprecise, uncertain, vague. But it is the logic, it is a logic that is used to describe the fuzziness. And why fuzziness? Because human reasoning, human comprehension is fuzzy. It is fuzzy, and therefore it is very important. Fuzzy logic is the theory of fuzzy sets. It is theory of fuzzy sets. A set that calibrate the vagueness. These fuzzy sets can calibrate vagueness or uncertainties or ambiguities. Fuzzy logic is based on the idea that all things acknowledge of degrees. All things acknowledge of degrees or shades. Temperature, height, speed, distance, beauty, all come on a sliding scale. How? Low temperature, high temperature. You may describe lukewarm, warm, say water. Hot, very hot, cold, very cold. Height, tall, mediocre, short. Speed, high speed, low speed, medium speed, normal speed, like that. Beauty, very beautiful, less beautiful, and so on. All come on a sliding scale. How fuzzy idea is communicated? How it is communicated? This photograph demonstrates the same. This box is too heavy. So too heavy is a fuzzy quantifier. Too heavy. This box could be light, too heavy. So too heavy is fuzzy. Therefore, we need a lighter one. So this person, how this person is talking? This box is too heavy. Too heavy is a fuzzy quantifier. He is speaking in his natural language, English. Another person is reacting to this statement. Therefore, we need a lighter one. So, lighter and too heavy, these are all fuzzy quantifiers. We have Boolean logic or crisp logic. Crisp logic uses sharp distinctions, either 0 or 1, true or false. It forces us to draw a line between members of class and non-members. Member of the class, and say for example, element is a member of class and another element is not a member of the class. This is a sharp distinction or clear-cut distinction, either a member or non-member. In fuzzy logic reflects how people think, how human beings think. It attempts to model our senses of words, our decision making, and our common sense. It is more human and it is used in intelligent systems. Professor Lotfi Zadeh is a founder of fuzzy sets theory. In this table, classical set versus fuzzy set, this idea is further explained. Five different persons are considered, their heights and the degree of membership of tall men. So, how we are defining the tall and then the membership, degree of membership of tall men. So, In tall men this category, what is the membership of this particular height? For example, Shankar. Shankar is a tall person, height 206 cm. In CRISP, we will assign this a membership as 1. Certainly, definitely, Shankar is tall, so 1. Amitabh, height 190 cm. Surely, Amitabh is also a tall person. So, in CRISP, how we assign the membership? It is 1. So, these two persons are tall. What about the others? Kapil, height of 175 cm. Ashok, height of 160 cm. Mahesh, with height of 155 cm. All these three persons, in CRISP logic, the membership is 0. In this set of tall men, the membership is 0. But how the things are interpreted in fuzzy sets or fuzzy logic? Shankar has a membership of 1. Amitabh, 190 cm height, membership 1. 175 cm height is also considered as a tall, but the membership is 0.8. So here membership varies from 0 to 1. In CRISP, membership is either 0 or 1. In case of fuzzy, membership ranges from 0 to 1. So for Kapil, with a height of 175 cm, membership is 0.8. Similarly, Ashok, with a height of 160 cm, membership could be 0.7. So Ashok is also considered as a tall, but the membership is only 0.7. And Mahesh, with a height of 155 cm, the membership is 0.4. So in fuzzy set, the memberships are assigned to all these persons or all these heights between 0 to 1. How can we control an air conditioner based on the conventional or classical control methods? Normally, we only switch the timer on or off based on the thermostat readings, keeping only one variable in consideration. But when the same solution is proposed by fuzzy logic model, the timer might be on and off concurrently based on the thermostat reading with a certain degree of truth in both the outputs. Concurrently means at the same time. Both of the outputs will fire simultaneously, but their level of execution would be different. A fuzzified air conditioner, what are the working principles? To maintain the room temperature at 26 degrees Celsius, this is the objective. To maintain the room temperature at 26 degrees Celsius, would turn on to a certain degree when the temperature is greater than 26, maybe. And similarly, would turn off when the temperature is less than 26. So this might happen, or this can happen in a fuzzified air conditioner. Thus, in fuzzy logic, the variable statements are combined based on the degree of truth or false, and then the final statement is analyzed. In the case of air conditioner, only temperature variable is monitored to simplify the application of fuzzy logic. However, other variables may be used or may be incorporated, such as humidity, desired airflow, moisture, and so on. What are the existing applications of fuzzy logic? We have numerous consumer applications: digital camera, camcorder, television, vacuum cleaner, clothes dryer, washing machine, hot water heater. In automotive, we have different applications: air conditioning, transmission control, suspension control, cruise control. There exist different industrial applications: extruding, mixing, furnace control, temperature control, conveyor control, and we have decision support applications: building, HVAC, medical diagnostics, transportation, elevator control. unlike PID control, proportional integral derivative control, that models the system or process being controlled. What is PID control? PID control models the system or process being controlled. It models. How fuzzy logic is different? Fuzzy logic emphasizes on the human operator's behavior. See, this is the distinction between PID control and fuzzy logic control. PID control simply models the system or process being controlled. But what does fuzzy logic in such situation? Fuzzy logic emphasizes on the human operator's behavior. Fuzzy logic describes a partial and not a strict set of membership normally associated with the Boolean logic that is used in microcontroller units and digital signal processors. Fuzzy logic describes a partial set of memberships, not strict. Strict means either 0 or 1, either element is a member or element is not a member, non-member. So in this perspective, fuzzy logic describes a partial, because the element may have some membership value. This membership value may vary from 0 to 1, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.7, 1 and so on. Rules indicated in natural language form membership to the fuzzy sets. And how memberships are decided, how memberships are defined? Rules indicated, rules defined in natural language, they form membership to the fuzzy sets.
In this example, fuzzy logic membership functions for pressure control is illustrated. Membership functions and rules are set up for the five pressure ranges. What are these five pressure ranges? Very low, low, normal, high and very high. Please notice this plot here on the y-axis or ordinate. Membership values are plotted and these values are varying from 0 to 1. On the x-axis or abscissa, pressure or vacuum values in percentage is plotted. How these values are varying from 0% to 100%. Now let us look at this plot carefully. For instance, this line AA, it denotes the pressure of 25%, and how this 25% is represented over here. 25% pressure is considered as very low with a membership of 0.85, and the same pressure it is considered as low with a membership of 0. Similarly, let us consider another value of the pressure, 30%. Now this 30% pressure is considered, it is considered as very low with a membership value of 0.75, and same pressure 30%, it is considered as low with a membership value of 0.3, with a membership value of 0.3. Here the fuzzy set permits membership with different grades, each expressed by a number in the interval from 0 to 1. The membership value for the intermediate locations is some number between 0 and 1, maybe 0.1, 0.3, 0.7, 0.85 and so on. A rule for the very high pressure may be, you can define the rule, it's a fuzzy rule. If the pressure is very high, then decrease the power greatly with a weight of 0.7 assigned for greatly. So this is the rule. If the pressure is very high, decrease the power. How the power is decreased? Power should be decreased greatly. And what is the meaning of greatly? Greatly means it has been assigned a weight of 0.7. Similarly, you can define a rule for low pressure. What is the rule? If the pressure is low, then increase the power slightly. See, here it is slightly. With a weight of 0.3. Why 0.3? Because this 0.3 weight has been assigned for slightly. The final part of the fuzzy logic process is defuzzification. What is defuzzification? This process takes a weighted average to translate the fuzzy outputs into a single crisp value. Now the translation or conversion from fuzzy outputs, very low, very high, low, so it has to be translated. Finally, it has to be translated into single crisp value, and this process is known as defuzzification. Output membership functions are typically defined by singletons, single value. A singleton in an 8-bit system is defined by an 8-bit value. Similarly, a singleton in a 16-bit system is defined by a 16-bit value, or in a 64-bit system is defined by a 64-bit value, but it represents the output value matching to the linguistic label of the output system. So what is the output value that is matching to the linguistic label of the output system? So that is the singleton basically. To simplify the implementation of fuzzy logic on existing microcontrollers or prevailing microcontrollers, a fuzzy kernel can be developed by microcontroller unit manufacturers. What is fuzzy kernel? It is also known as a fuzzy engine. It's a software that carries out the three basic tasks of fuzzy logic. First task, fuzzification. Second task, rule evaluation. And third task, defuzzification. As shown in the following figure in the next slide, the fuzzy inference unit, FIU, accepts system inputs and information from the knowledge base for each step of the process. All application specific information is contained in the knowledge base that is developed independently from the fuzzy inference program. This is the block diagram for fuzzy software inference unit. It is also known as fuzzy inference unit, FIU. You can see three basic building blocks over here. The first block, what is this first block? It is supplied by application expert. It is supplied by application expert, a user, a designer, developer. So what are the ingredients of this block? Input membership functions. So expert must specify or prescribe or define input membership functions. Expert, application expert must define rules. And third ingredient or third building sub-block, it is output membership function. So it is the responsibility of the application expert to specify input membership functions, output membership functions and rules. Then we have intermediate block, it is the system inputs. In the system inputs, three important processes are listed. First is fuzzification. Because input membership functions, the output of the input membership functions, it is received by this fuzzification, this particular module. The second process is rule evaluation. These rules are presented to the rule evaluation block. And the third process is defuzzification. So output membership functions, it is connected to the defuzzification. So the response of output membership function, it is supplied to defuzzification. And for fuzzification, system inputs are received, or system inputs are accepted by this fuzzification module, and the outputs, the system outputs are produced by defuzzification module. Then we have the last block, and this is the runtime calculation results. Here two important submodules are present, fuzzy inputs and here fuzzy outputs. Because fuzzification, after fuzzification we need these fuzzy inputs, we need fuzzy inputs and fuzzy outputs after rule evaluation. These are runtime results, runtime calculation results. The fuzzy inference unit FIU accepts system inputs and information from the knowledge base. System inputs and information from the knowledge base for each step of the process. With fuzzy logic, so-called complex applications in practice are being easily controlled. This is our observation nowadays. Rules in a fuzzy system often hold true even if the operating parameters of that system change. Even if the operating parameters of that system vary or change drastically, even then the rules in a fuzzy system often hold true. So this is the advantage of fuzzy system. This is unlike the situation in conventional control system. So this is not possible in conventional control system, and therefore we normally prefer to use fuzzy logic control.
Fuzzy logic does not need special hardware. The software requirements are low based on a limited number of rules to describe the system. For most control tasks, software running on standard processors can accomplish fuzzy logical operations. Specialized hardware simplifies code development and enhances computational performance for low cost applications. So fuzzy logic control finds applications in say washing machines, camcorders, smart television sets and so on. Fuzzy logic permits 8-bit microcontroller units to complete tasks that may have otherwise needed a more powerful microcontroller unit, such as a RISC processor. So fuzzy logic permits only 8-bit microcontroller units, 8-bit microcontrollers to complete numerous tasks. For such tasks, otherwise, more powerful microcontroller units such as RISC processors would be required. Fuzzy logic control is also used in mobile robot. Fuzzy logic has been successfully employed with multiple sensors to develop a mobile security robot for assessing the environment in an art gallery. This figure shows the block diagram of mobile robot, how fuzzy logic control is used in mobile robot. So in this figure, fuzzy logic's certainty engine in the robot weighs multiple variables, produces a composite picture from data provided by the sensors, and achieves real-time threat identification and assessment. So numerous sensors are used in this application. For instance, temperature sensor, gas sensor, smoke sensor, humidity sensor, passive infrared scan, then radar scan. So all these sensors, they have a fusion over here, and then the output of the sensor is acquired or is collected by the data acquisition module. So it performs data acquisition tasks. Actually, then it also derives some inputs from task table. A user may define task table, and then the data acquisition task it delivers its response or output to blackboard readings and buffers. Blackboard readings and buffers. Then we have a module, certainty engine task. So, and certainty engine task, certainty engine task, it also derives its input from task table. And another input to this certainty engine task will be from target acquisition and tracing. Then in this flow, we have blackboard threat scores and alarms, blackboard threat scores and alarms, and target acquisition and tracing, and we have feedback over here. The output of blackboard readings and buffers is given to this target acquisition and tracing. Similarly, the output of certainty engine task is also given to target acquisition and tracing. So this is how we have a sensor fusion here to offer input to the fuzzy logic certainty engine of mobile robot. And it certainly achieves a real-time threat identification and assessment in the art gallery. This robot can analyze data based on location, the time of day, historical trends, and external conditions. A wide range of safety threats, detrimental, hazardous to art objects has been identified by the robot during a 3 year evaluation, 36 months evaluation. So it has been proved, it has been confirmed. Air quality assessment for conditions harmful to humans is a clear extension of this technology. So the same technology can be used for air quality assessment for conditions harmful to humans. Let us consider artificial intelligence defined sensing. So what is the role of artificial intelligence in sensing or in smart sensors? We are witnessing a stupendous advancement in artificial intelligence technologies, and these technologies have given rise to powerful new methods to analyze and derive novel insights from sensor data streams and external data sets. While this trend classified as AI defined sensing, so this trend is classified as AI defined sensing, it is already obvious in areas like computer vision for analyzing image sensor data. These new software capabilities are unlocking or uncovering applications for a range of sensor types, including mechanical sensors, acoustic sensors, and thermal sensors, greatly increasing the utility of sensors, and they are driving the world market. With the advent and growth of artificial intelligence technologies concentrated in machine learning, the capabilities of software-defined sensors are increasing at a breakneck pace or speed. Artificial intelligence for analyzing sensor data, now classified as AI-defined sensors, enables far more rugged predictions, robust predictions, forecast, and classifications using sensor signals as compared to other methods like physics-based models. The trend of artificial intelligence adding new functionalities. New functionalities are added to sensors. Intelligence is added to sensor. Decision-making abilities, intelligence, is already apparent in some use cases, some cases. For instance, computer vision. Sensor types ranging from temperature sensors to magnetic sensors will all be influenced by this trend. Artificial intelligence and sensor types are illustrated in this figure. On the left hand side, sensor categories are shown. Four different categories: physical sensors, electromagnetic radiation sensors, environmental sensors, and electrical and magnetic sensors. Now, AI and sensor type categorized by detected stimulus. Stimulus or excitation signal or input signals. So what are the different types AI defined sensors? The first one is mechanical. Mechanical sensors, for example, pressure, acceleration, strain, etc. Acoustic sensors, for example, microphone, ultrasonic. Optical sensors, for example, image sensor, spectrometer. Other electromagnetic radiation sensor, for example, radars, X-rays. Thermal sensors, for example, temperature sensors. Chemical sensors, for example, gas sensors, different gas sensors, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, etc. Magnetic sensors, for example, magnetometer. Electrical properties sensor, for example, electroencephalograph, electrocardiogram, ECG, voltmeter, etc. On the right hand side, heat map is shown over here. different shades of violet indicate different number of patents. So very dark shade of violet, it indicates very high number of patents, greater than 9000. Lightest shade of violet indicates very low number of patents, less than 1000. For example, let us consider the case of mechanical sensors. Health and medical, there are four different domain of applications, application areas: health and medical, second one is automotive, third one is industrial, and then fourth is consumer. For mechanical sensors, in this application area, health and medical, very high number of patents are filed. For automotive, high number of patents, that is 6000 to 9000. Industrial, very high. Consumer, very high, greater than 9000. Similarly, one can analyze the situation for each type of the sensor. And here, patent activity since 2012, it is demonstrated, and it shows the use of each sensor type combined with AI for each industry. AI and machine learning, they are correlated with one another. AI and machine learning, what are the different types of sensors? At the bottom you see doorbell sensor, fall detection sensor, glass breaking sensor, oven on sensor, water running sensor. These are all AI defined sensors, intelligent sensors. We use cloud computation, cloud computing or edge computing. Then we also consider real sensors such as accelerometer and microphone. So real sensors such as accelerometer and microphone, they are integrated along with AI defined sensors, such as all these sensors. So we have a sensor fusion between real sensors and AI defined sensors, sensor area network. AI defined sensors encode the sensing functionality inside AI models. Different AI applications are exhibited in this slide. In heavy industries, Matsushita, Siemens, Stora Enso, home appliances, automobiles, spacecrafts, etc. These are all the references used in order to prepare this session on application of fuzzy logic control in smart sensors. Thank you.